Let us discuss about the memory organization of 8051 microcontroller. In this, first let me discuss about the RAM structure. Internal RAM of 128 bytes. At this point, we have already discussed in the features of 8051 microcontroller and how this 128 bytes of internal RAM is organized. It is organized into four register banks 00 to 1F, 16 bytes bit addressable 20 to 2F, 80 bytes of general purpose data memory 30 to 7F. Let me discuss in detail about the RAM structure of 8051 microcontroller. There are 128 bytes of RAM in 8051. The 128 bytes of RAM inside the 8051 are assigned addresses 00 to 7FH. These 128 bytes are divided into three different groups as follows. A total of 32 bytes from locations 00 to 1F, this 00 to 1F. Again, this data, again it is divided into four banks, which is of eight registers R0 to R7 and also one stack, and a total of 16 bytes from other locations. 16 bytes from other locations 20H to 2FH are set aside for bit addressable read or write memory. A total of 80 bytes from location 30H to 7FH are used for read and write storage, or what is normally called a scratch pad. These 80 locations of RAM are widely used for the purpose of storing data and parameters by 8051 programmers. Coming to the discussion of register banks in 8051 microcontroller, a total of 32 bytes of RAM are set aside for the register banks and stack. These 32 bytes are divided into four banks of registers, in which each bank has eight registers R0 to R7. RAM locations from 0 to 7 are set aside for bank 0 of R0 to R7, where R0 is RAM location 0, R1 is RAM location 1, R2 is RAM location 2, and so on, until memory location 7, which belongs to R7 of bank 0, the second bank of registers R0 to R7 starts at RAM location 8 and it goes to location 0FH. Same like third set from 10H to 17H and fourth set from 18H to 1FH. The figure explains clearly, like each bank registers again contains a general purpose registers R0 to R7. And bank 1 uses same RAM space as the stack. This is a major problem in programming the 8051. We must either not use register bank 1 or allocate another area of RAM for the stack. Coming to the default register bank, if RAM locations 00 to 1F are set aside for the four register banks, which register bank of R0 to R7 do we have access to when the 8051 is powered up? The answer is register bank 0, that is RAM locations 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 are accessed with the names R0, R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6 and R7 when programming the 8051 microcontroller. It is much easier to refer to these RAM locations with names such as R0, R1, so on, than by their memory locations. But how to switch register banks? So if you want to access, now we have four register banks. If we want to access any of the four register banks, we have to access from PSW bits bank selection. Just let me go to that. See, this is the program status word, which is of 8 bits. Here PSW word, third bit and fourth bit. We have two register bank select registers are there. If both are 0 and 0, we are going to select bank 0. 0, 1 means bank 1 selection, 1, 0 bank 2 selection, and 1, 1 is bank 3 selection. So D3 and D4 bits of register PSW are often referred to as PSW4 and PSW3 since they can be accessed by a bit addressable instructions SETB and CLR. Stack in 8051 microcontroller. The stack is a section of RAM used by the CPU to store information temporarily. This information could be data or an address. The CPU needs this storage area since there are only a limited number of registers. But how stacks are accessed in 8051 microcontroller? If the stack is a section of RAM, there must be registers inside the CPU to point to it. The register used to access the stack is called stack pointer. The stack pointer in the 8051 is only 8 bits wide, which means that it can take values of 00 to FFH. When the 8051 is powered up, the stack pointer register contains value 07. This means that RAM location 08 is the first location used for the stack by the 8051. The storing of a CPU register in the stack is called a push, and pulling the contents of the stack back into your CPU register is called a pop. In other words, a register is pushed onto the stack to save it and popped off the stack to retrieve it. The job of the stack pointer is very critical when push and pop actions are performed. Pushing onto the stack. In the 8051, the stack pointer points to the last used location of the stack. As we push data onto the stack pointer is incremented by 1. Notice that this is different from any microprocessor, especially 8086 microprocessor, in which the stack pointer is decremented when the data is pushed onto the stack. This is the RAM structure, which is of 128 bytes, the upper 128 bytes of internal RAM, no bit addressable spaces. So these are the SFR, special function registers, memory map. Let us discuss about the special purpose registers. Accumulator, B register, program status word, stack pointer, data pointer, port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3, interrupt priority control, interrupt enable control, and timers related. Already we have discussed, we have two timers, timer 0 and timer 1. And related to the timers, we have timer or counter mode control, timer or counter control, timer or counter higher byte and lower byte, because as 8051 microcontroller is limited to 8 bit, and it contains two timers which is of 16 bit. So it cannot store complete 16 bytes of data. So dividing the timer into two parts, like lower byte and higher byte. So timer 0, again it is divided into TH0 and TL0, lower byte of timer 0 and higher byte of timer 0, same like lower byte of timer 1 and higher byte of timer 1. In this, accumulator is one of the important general purpose register which is used to store the data, perform operations, and B register, which is also of 8 bit, and program status register, which is of 8 bit. And coming to the data pointer DPTR, again it is of 16 bits, but again it is divided into two bytes, low byte and high byte, which is of DPL and DPH, lower byte of data pointer and higher byte of data pointer. And we have already discussed that four ports are associated with the 8051 microcontroller. Each port is of 8 bit, and all four ports are used as a bidirectional input output. And related to the interrupts, we have two registers which is of 8 bit. One is interrupt priority and another one is interrupt enable registers, which we are going to discuss further.